Box and pointer notation is a new addition to environment diagrams. So, let me tell you about a property of data types. A method for combining data values satisfies the closure property if the result of combination can itself be combined using the same method. And closure is the key to power in any means of combination because it permits us to create hierarchical structures. So what's going on here? I'm explaining that if when you combine data values together, you can then combine those values together, etc., then you can build a hierarchy. Hierarchical structures are made up of parts, which then cells have parts, and those have parts, and those have parts, and so on. That's what I mean by hierarchical, and that's important because that lets us represent things in the world that are also hierarchical. And to do that, we need the closure property of data. A simple example of this is that lists can contain other lists as elements. So box and pointer notation helps us represent that closure property of lists. Lists are represented as a row of index-labeled adjacent boxes, one per element, and each box contains either a primitive value or points to a compound value. So here are two examples of lists. A really simple one, the pair, which just contains 1, 2, and then a nested list, or hierarchical structure, which contains as its first element another list with 1 and 2 in it. Here, this one is an empty list, and then the third element is a list which itself has lists within it. The box and pointer diagrams allow us to visualize this structure. So pair is bound to a list containing 1 and 2. 1 and 2 are the values. These little 0 and 1 are the index labels. So I said index labeled adjacent boxes, and this is exactly what I'm talking about. And we write up here that it's a list, because actually there are other sequence types in Python, and we want to distinguish them, but we draw them all the same way. So a nested list is a list with 3 adjacent boxes because it has 3 elements. The first element is the list 1, 2. The second element is an empty list, which we got from this expression. And then the third element is a list with 2 lists in it. So the third element is a list with 2 lists in it. And this list has 3 and false and none, all of which are primitive values. And this list has 4 and then a function, the function that you get by evaluating lambda 5. So I draw this complex example just so you can see the kinds of things that happen when you use box and pointer notation. You can in fact see the hierarchical structure of a nested list.